Hello and welcome to module number 4 on animation, possibly the part of the course that you've been waiting for. So I'm super excited for this module because I just think it's going to be one of the most valuable in terms of contributing to the entire vibe that your video has. So if you're feeling fresh and you're feeling ready, then let's get underway. Now, just first of all, for a little bit of context, we've got our sales knowledge, we've executed on that, and it's interesting in its own right. But there's something so deeply meaningful, I think, about creating art. And when you actually combine the two, that's when the magic happens for your business. It's when you increase the perceived value to your customer and also when you build that trust. So we've got our sales out of the way, we've got our artwork alongside the storyboard, and we've been iterating upon what we've got throughout the modules. We've been kind of tweaking as we've been going along so that we're happy with everything we've got. Well, that leaves just for one thing, After Effects. So I just want to start off this module by introducing once more Little Booba and Kiki. You remember them from module 1 on script writing when I was explaining how what we write is deeply connected to what we see on screen. Now that we're in the animation module, I'd like to develop this concept a step further for you so that you understand the very fundamentals of animation. We're now looking at Booba and Kiki from the standpoint of actual motion, rather than just illustration. And so let's see what Booba and Kiki might look like in real life if they had a heartbeat. We can see that Booba there might be expected to waver a little, laze about before getting to the other side. It's kind of almost like a leaf blowing in the wind. It's slow, it's gradual, and it's quite therapeutic in a way. But Kiki, on the other hand, doesn't mess about. She's right on her game, and she's zigzagging along there right to the end. Of course, zigzag is actually another great term to describe this phenomenon. So both of these shapes move in ways that complement their actual shape. And this animation has solely come from the relationship between the form of what we're seeing and the relationship it naturally has with the way we speak and the way we animate. Remember, this isn't some complex lesson that we're going to have to consider before doing anything, but it is good to be aware of this principle because for an animation video, it helps a lot in writing, selecting artwork, animating, and later on producing sound for a video which complements the action on screen. It allows us to make animation decisions based on how we intend to read the voiceover, or you may already have it, and whether you introduce bangs and wallops to emphasize what people are seeing. Now, I created this sequence for another reason, and that was to give a simple demonstration of the most fundamental building block in After Effects animation, and that's keyframing. So a little later, we're actually going to come back to this animation here when we begin our first practical lesson in After Effects on keyframing, and we'll learn how I managed to make these shapes move across the screen in different ways. Just a quick note here on learning styles for the downloadable projects during this module. I think it's vitally important to know how best you learn personally. And simply, I divide that into two categories. You're either a kinesthetic learner, the kind of person who doesn't read the manual before you use that new gadget, or you're the kind of person who wants to sit down and learn what all those knobs and buttons do in the instruction manual before you press the power button. And the instruction manual style can either be visual or auditory. And so here we have kind of the three broad learning styles which you may have read about, which is kinesthetic, visual, and auditory. Whichever you are, that's absolutely fine. Of course, this course owes itself to the visual and auditory learners, but personally, I'm actually a very kinesthetic learner. So I like to get my hands dirty, and I feel like I learn best when I'm hands-on and building my muscle memory. So if that's you as well, feel free to download all of the projects for After Effects, place them in your folder system and have a play around. Of course, I recommend you watch the videos as well at some point to really understand how best to execute in them and not build bad habits. But I wanted to spend a moment to possibly give you a little more freedom in some of these projects, which can be a little complex. If you're happy watching the videos first, that's absolutely fine as well. Okay, onwards. So briefly, our first introduction to After Effects is going to be as follows. First, we are going to set up a project from scratch so that we all start from square one before getting on to how we are going to import assets through the folder system. You'll see number one, why it's so important, but also how easy it is with this approach. And then we'll spend the remaining time we have in this module getting hands-on with 11 projects teaching animation techniques for you to immediately adapt into your own demo videos.